proper. Me no look nobody face, no papa. Clean and papa, me waistly than copper. Man a ragamuffin, not a rapper. Check my settings, can't find no iOS. My ratings stronger than SOS. Your love.
And what's up, Ghana? What's up, everybody? You're live on Starbuzz, and we're live inside Passions. It's Layback Thursday, ladies and gentlemen, and we're getting an exclusive interview with the main man, Mr. George Mesa Britton, the CEO of GB Interactive. I've got my main man right here. What's good, Mr. Britton?
That's alright.
Alright, so real quick, you're live on Starbuzz TV, and you're about to go for your chit chat at the Layback Thursday. I think it's your first time.
First time as a guest, but second time here. Yeah. The first time I came with my artist sketcher, which was very successful. So I'm looking forward to this, and I believe it's going to be very successful too.
All right, so we're not going to waste my time because it's got a whole lot of questions to answer over there. Quick and easy.
Welcome, welcome. Okay, so you had it's not just a gentleman and a handsome guy as well. It's got so many qualities as well. Welcome, Mr. George.
Thank you.
Well, I can say almost 70% of these people here know you. So the main reason why we're here tonight is we host people on this platform for people to know them, what they do. They tell us what's going on with them, their business, what's going down with them. You tell us about yourself. They've got questions to ask you, then you answer them as well. That's the whole deal. So who is Mr. George Mesa Britton?
So yeah, like I said, my name is George. I'm an artist manager, a blogger, and like an entrepreneur, like I said earlier. I'll begin with the blogger. I started blogging way back in 2004 with GhanaMusic.com, where internet was very scarce in this country. We saw the light, so we followed the light till today, where internet is so easy to come by. We ran GhanaMusic.com from then till about 2012, where I decided to build a brand called the George Britton brand. Before the George Britton brand was built, I ventured into artist management. So the year 2008-2009, I started working with an artist called Nilante. Nilante is a reggae artist. Fortunately for us, we were able to win Ghana Music Award as an artist manager. From Nilante, I moved to Akonana, where we had songs like Mugu, Wash and Wear. Then I went on break for a while. So after the break, then I came in for Ketcher. I started talking to Ketcher where they were far away in New York. So we started working when they were in New York and I was in Accra. So they produced a song called Diabetes. So yeah, it's everything with Ketcher started from Diabetes. And then came GB Interactive. Before GB Interactive, there was GeorgeBritton.com, or there was George Britton brand. GB Interactive is a marketing company. It's an agency, marketing agency, which of course have pretty good clients out there. Yeah.
Can you please put your hands together for Mr. George Britton once again? Return us all. So I think you can start writing down your questions, but I'm going to do the questions. I'll start first. Mr. George, what has been your greatest challenge in managing artists? I think you mentioned about three artists. What has been your greatest challenge, and what do you think is really being difficult in managing artists in Ghana?
Well, down here, systems don't work like in the Western world, where a system works so you can easily recoup the money that you invest. There are no investors in Ghana Music, so it makes it very tough to actually achieve some of the plans you want to achieve, because where there are investors, you can easily gain what you are planning to do. But down here, you have to hustle, you have to play shows, you have to do everything possible to make things go. So I think number one problem here is the finances. Yeah.
Okay, so next question, please. Who has a question for Mr. George Britton?
Okay, so Mr. Bayansi, you want to ask some questions?
Yeah. Honorable, please, are you married? Are you a married person?
Well, Mr. George, somebody wants to know if you're married.
Yes, I think I'm a weak old husband. Yeah.
Wow. Yo, put your hands together for the man. He's a weak old married man.
Alright? No, I chose to not to wear it, you know, because yeah, just a weak old man, yeah. No, no, he actually scared me, but because I don't want to bark with it, you know.
Alright, anybody else?
Somebody here was as a Christian, please.
Yeah, I want to know what you consider why being an artist manager.
Alright. So before I go in for an artist, I look at two things. I look at the, first of all, the character of the artist, and secondly, the brand. I think the music comes later. Because every Tom and Dick can make a hit song, but it takes a real big artist to be signed to. I mean, the reason why I went in for Ketcher was, even before Ketcher came, I spoke to a lot of artists, you understand? But I had to look at a lot of things before I went in for Ketcher, and I don't think I've regretted working with Ketcher, because Ketcher has equally built a GB brand, you understand? So. You need to be a very humble artist. You need to be somebody who is very hungry. Because if you're not hungry, if you just depend on one hit song, you ain't gonna last in this game. Yeah.
All right, so question answered. Anybody else, please?
Okay, I want him to be sincere and fair. What are the things you don't like about your artist, Ketche?
Okay, I think they pray too much. Yeah. I think Ketcher prays too much, so probably if there is something I might not like about them, that would be one of it. But hey, I enjoy it though, but I'm just saying it's too much.
Mr. George, what's up? What's your best quality as a music entrepreneur? Your best qualities as a music entrepreneur? Yeah.
Your best qualities as a music entrepreneur?
First of all, I believe in the artists I work with, because if I don't believe in you, I will not be motivated to work harder. Yeah, so I think it's the belief in the artist. Next week, you're bringing something that will keep people laughing. So watch out for, okay, let me just read the news here. Ketcher Lil Wayne from Kumasi. It's a bit of a hilarious song, which I think I'm breaking the news here. We're gonna release this song next week, Friday. Aside that, expect more from GB Records, as with the artist Ketcher. Expect more for the georgebrinton.com. It's an entertainment website, so I'm urging you all to visit the website to check out all your latest entertainment news. georgebrinton.com. We are very much alive on social media. That is George Brinton GH. Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, and georgebrinton.com on Facebook. Like I said, branding is a perception that you have about a product or a person. We'll spend the whole day talking about this, but I guess if I'm to throw some questions at you people, and to ask the ladies, Sude, I want you to do me a favor. Can you please mention top three Ghanaian artists?
Top three Ghanaian artists. I mean, the ladies on this table, so who's going to answer?
Sack. Stoneboy.
Atomis.
Atomis. All right. Okay, so anybody else has different opinions?
Ketcher.
Anybody else, please?
So my guys, Altobe, Sarkodie, and Bing, that's all.
Top three. Okay, so you think it's top three?
Sarkodie, Altobe, and Bing.
If the mic is to go to everybody here, each and every one of you will mention Sarkodie. Probably Stoneboy Shatta will be in there. But you see, last year, There were lots of hate songs in Ghana. Can you name any of them for me?
Yeah.
Hate songs. I mean the songs. Okay. Brother, brother. Okay. Okay. Okay, so I'm not disrespecting any artist here. Neither am I looking down upon any artist here. But it looks like some artists are just working on their songs. I think Dilemma was the biggest song last year in Ghana, right? But nobody mentioned Gasolet's name. The reason is
they're branded.
Okay, so okay, so what happens is most artists pay too much attention to the songs, leaving the image behind the songs out. That's how come that when the song goes off, the artist doesn't exist. I think we can name a lot of artists who have had hate songs, but they are not anywhere closer to the picture. So, an example is Becca. Becca is not singing, but she's still got a brand, right?
Yeah.
When was the last time you heard Sarkodie's hate song?
No. Yeah.
It's Kanta, it's something else, it's just rapping. I mean, the songs are not banging in the club, but you're all calling Sarkodie's name. Mary. Shout out to Kanta. Okay, so when we talk about artist branding, we're talking about the image you have in mind when you think about the artist. That is how come an example is Kanye West. Hello? That's how come you have an artist like Kanye West. He doesn't care about what you think of him. He's always in the news. He's holding a brand for himself. I don't remember any of Kanye West, the song he released the last 2 years. But I know there's a man in the States called Kanye West releasing music. So, to my upcoming artists in the building, when you're coming up, yes, we need a hit song to dance. But at the end of the day, when the song goes down, you gotta stand. So producers, a good image behind a brand, can equally a good song. Yeah? Okay, so this is a little bit I'll talk about branding, especially artist branding for today. The other one will come up later in heaven.
Well, so I think that will be it. Can you please put your hands together for the man last time? He said it all, Mr. Britton. It's been nice having you guys here. We're hoping to request you once again. And then this coming year, yeah? I mean, this is the purpose.
Okay, so yeah. Big thanks to WhatsApp, Sam, Jingles, Coaches, and the entire team for holding us down here. I think Ketcher's song will be first played in this building. Ketcher Low and something beautiful, which will be coming out pretty soon, next week actually. We would like to release it here first, so thank you for hosting us.
I want to thank you for having me too, Mr. Jeff Britton. And it's not leaving though, so if you want to take pictures, you can come for it and take some pictures with the gentleman.
Special delivery. Yeah.